करो कुछ ऐसा देश का सम्मान बढ़ जाए, मरो तो ऐसा तिरंगों की शान बढ़ जाए, भरो पिचकारी ऐसे तीनों रंगों की, तन पर पड़े तो हिंदुस्तान बन जाए।
Today we all know that we are celebrating the Constitution Day. Our country is celebrating its 75th year of independence as the Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav. In order to commemorate the day of adoption of our Constitution, the occasion of Samvidhan Divas, that is Constitution Day, is also being organized with Jan Bhagidari on a mega scale. On this occasion today, Honorable President of India will be leading the celebration of Constitution Day live from Central Hall of Parliament from 11 a.m. It has just started only. The occasion will be graced by Honorable Vice President, Honorable Prime Minister, Honorable Speaker, Ministers, MPs and other dignitaries, and the whole of India will be part of this celebration through live streaming of the function on Sansad TV and other online. Sorry, I missed out to address all the dignitaries here. Respected Sri Niti Tara, Advocate, Guwahati High Court, thanks for accepting our invitation and having come before us as a spokesperson. Respected Sri Mukesh Prasad Sir, faculty member of Himalaya University, and thank you for always being with us.
On my subject matter, let me formally roll with addressing respected Member Secretary, Madam Chai of the Arunachal Pradesh Legal Service Authority, here Dr. Mukesh Prasad, HOD of the Law Department, Himalaya University, my younger colleague who has accompanied me this morning, and my dear student friends, and of course the staff of the legal service authorities here who are assisting us. Well, before I embark on the topic that has been allotted to me, is making of Indian Constitution and the constitutional right of tribals of Northeast India. Therefore, my speech has been structured in two parts. First, I would be giving a small outline in bullet points about the making of the Constitution of India. And then the second part would be very interesting about the constitutional right of the tribals. Here, not only the thing that I am going to deliberate, how the tribal rights have gained momentum in the international level, the national perspective, with the provisions in the Constitution of India and with the perspective to Arunachal Pradesh. Well, a while ago, Madam has given a brief background about the Constitution, how it was framed. And there too, and also I'm enlightened by the speech on the status of judiciary. Well, I tell you, I have written the first law book of Arunachal, that is easy reference on criminal law. I hope many of you are having it, a copy of it, that was released in 2019 on 21st of July. And that book is exhausted. Initially it was 10,000 copies were printed, but within 2 months period it was sold out. So now I have requested the publisher to get you a student copy, which would be costing around 200 rupees. So that new edition, first edition, will be coming out very shortly, and hope it will be at your hands soon. And secondly, which Madam has referred to, and of course, this the Civil Code Act was drafted by me when I was Additional Advocate General of Arunachal Pradesh during President rule. I accepted the post of Additional Advocate General because that was a history, you know, we cannot forget. During President rule, if an advocate is appointed to a government position, it is by the order of the President of India, not on the recommendation of the political basis. So I accepted that I was in that office for nearly 1.5 years, then I left. That is how I come before you today. This morning we had a program at High Court. I attended there, then I made a few speeches over there, then I rushed back here. And then afternoon I have a cases listed before the court, then I am rushing back. But I'll try to paraphrase within 20-25 minutes, although 30 minutes have been allotted to me. So dear friends, well, the December is a remarkable time in the journey of India to become an independent country, because it was exactly 71 years back on 9th December 1946 that the Constituent Assembly of India sat together for the first time to draft the Constitution. And not just the Constitution, but also acquired national flag, anthem, and lot more, which accelerated the journey of attaining independence. Now the Constitution. The Jenning, Luther Glick, all those, Professor Bernard Shaw, they all define the Constitution. But since I am not on the academic side anymore, even then, I'll just throw a light on what is the Constitution of India. As you know, it is a well-established fact that Constitution of India is the most supreme law of the country and torchbearer of fundamental political code, powers and duties of government, procedures, directive principles and duties of the citizen. It is the longest constitution of the world, of any sovereign countries in the world, containing its original form of 395 articles, 8 schedules, to which additions have been made through subsequent amendments. At present, it contains 448 articles, 25 schedules, 12 parts, and 150 amendments. As you know, even the Parliament is not allowed to overpower the Constitution because of its constitutional supremacy over Parliament. Supremacy and the fact that it was framed through Constituent Assembly, which was headed by Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, and not Parliament and its member. So therefore the basic structure doctrine, you know, that is Article 368 of the Constitution of India, and this will always read in conjunction with Article 13. Any law made in derogation of the fundamental right would be void. So these are, even though A.K. Gopalan judgment of 1950, then L.C. Golaknath, M.C. Mehta, then Kesavananda Bharati judgment. These are the judgments you law student ought to read if you want to understand the Constitution of India. Now let me dwell on how the process of making of the Constitution that took place. We call it as the initiation of making of the constitutions. You see, the beginning of the idea to draft constitution came up in 1928 when the All Parties Conference summoned a committee in order to draft constitution, and that report came to be known as the Nehru Report. Now then what happens? In 1934, the idea for forming of the Constituent Assembly took place. As because that particular relevant point of time, India was divided into various princely provinces, right? And various laws of the Britishers were in governance. So there was no unanimity among ourselves. So therefore, it was a paramount requirement for us to have the Constituent Assembly and to debate the same.
Sir, Mukesh, to say something on the program, since this program has been organized in a very short notice, so we didn't get a chance to give a particular topic to sir, so we want to hear something at least in this program.
And we are also very honored that with your presentation and all, you have enlightened our...
Of the opinion that directive principles of state policies are not a fixed futures of fundamental rights can be made enforceable before the court of law.
As a law student, you people are law students, it becomes your responsibility.
Myself, Srimati Javed Pruchai, I'm Member Secretary of Arunachal Pradesh, State Legal Services Authority, Arunachal Pradesh.
Ma'am, what is this program actually for?
हम लोग सभी जानते हैं कि हमारा इंडिपेंडेंस का 75 ईयर्स हो गया, इसी के तहत हम लोग आज़ादी का अमृत महोत्सव मना रहे हैं और आज के दिन है कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया को अडॉप्ट किया है, आज का दिन संविधान दिवस भी हम लोग मना रहे हैं। इसी को ऑब्जर्व करते हुए आज हमने हिमालय यूनिवर्सिटी से स्टूडेंट्स को बुलाया है, अबाउट मोर देन 50 स्टूडेंट्स दे हैव कम हियर, दे हैव पार्टिसिपेटेड एंड देन वी हैड रिसोर्स पर्सन एडवोकेट तीति तारा, गुवाहाटी हाईकोर्ट से भी आए थे, उन्होंने भी अपना टॉपिक लिया है। वी हैव फैकल्टी मेंबर डॉक्टर मुकेश प्रसाद ऑल्सो फ्रॉम हिमालय यूनिवर्सिटी, सो वी हैव डिस्कस एंड ब्रीफ अबाउट द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एंड आई हैव ऑल्सो डिस्कस अबाउट द ब्रीफ हिस्टोरी अबाउट द अरुणाचल जुडिशियरी।
मैम, इन अरुणाचल मोस्टली अरुणाचल पीपल दे आर वेरी कंफ्यूज अबाउट लीगल राइट्स एंड लॉज, सो व्हाट मैसेज विल यू गिव टू देम?
As a member secretary and then this salsa also, we are giving timely awareness to the public. We recently Pan India movement, maybe from 2nd October to 14 November, we have given awareness in every nook and corners of the state. We have 25 districts. In some of the district, we don't even have judicial officers, even don't have courts. But still, with the help of the learned legal aid councils, paralegal volunteers, NGOs and other stakeholders, we could cover all the villages. वहाँ पर भी हम लोग ने अच्छी तरह से बताया कि आप लोगों को अगर कुछ भी लीगल प्रॉब्लम्स होगा तो आप लोग लीगल सर्विसेज का भी हेल्प ले सकते हैं। उसी प्रोग्राम के तहत हम लोगों ने उन लोगों को बेसिक लॉस के बारे में बताया है एंड देन राइट्स लाइक अंडर लीगल सर्विस अथॉरिटी एक्ट 1987 सेक्शन 12 ऑल्सो देर आर सर्टन कैटेगरीज लाइक हु आर एंटाइटल्ड फॉर फ्री लीगल सर्विसेज, उसके बारे में भी हम लोगों ने बताया है। एज पर सेक्शन 12 ऑफ दैट एक्ट, एनी वुमन चाइल्ड एनी वन इन द कस्टडी से दे आर वेरियस कैटेगरीज हु कैन अवेल फ्री लीगल सर्विस अथॉरिटी, उसके बारे में बताया है एंड इट वॉज वेरी हेल्पफुल। थ्रू मोबाइल वैन ऑल्सो वी हैव इम्पार्टेड द नॉलेज, जब हम लोगों ने नॉलेज दिया है गाँव गाँव जाके हम लोगों ने जैसे बताया है, now we are receiving application from the victims, they are approaching us, they have stated that after the awareness camp they came to know about the free legal services and they have approached us and we are giving them the all the benefits of the legal services, that way we are imparting them about the legal knowledges.
Okay ma'am, today how far do you think this program was successful?
It was very successful. I have seen how patiently all the students they have heard also. like we have learned a speaker like Advocate T.T. Tara also. In very detail he has mentioned about the development of constitution, also about the tribal rights of Arunachal Pradesh also he has briefed, and all the students also I believe that they have fully benefited out of it.
Myself Mukesh Prasad, HOD, Department of Law from Himalayan University. We had a proposal from Arunachal Pradesh State Legal Service Authority that they are going to celebrate the 72nd Constitution Day, and they have made the proposal that they want to celebrate this Constitution Day with, in collaboration with our university, and we were very pleased to have the proposal from Arunachal Pradesh State Legal Service Authority, and then the program was hosted in the conference hall of the Arunachal Pradesh State Legal Service Authority, and many of our students, yes, you see here, they are present and they have witnessed the celebration of 72nd Constitutional Day, and here our members of Arunachal Pradesh, Member Secretary of Arunachal Pradesh State Legal Service Authority, Joglu Madam, she has briefly explained on making of the historical background of the Constitution of India, and out of her presentation, many of our students were enlightened, and they got quite knowledge. Was the topic on which she speak was quite beneficial for all of us, including especially for the student sections. And T.T. Tara sir, Advocate T.T. Tara sir, he also spoke on Constitution of India, initiating of making of the Constitution of India. Moreover, one of the most important topic which he has spoke upon is the constitutional right of the tribals of the Northeast Indian. And is, as you know, the Himalayan University is a Itanagar, and maximum of the students, they belong from indigenous community. So speaking on constitutional right, especially for the tribals people, was quite beneficial for all of the my students, and they have grabbed all the opportunities of today's program.
Sir, how many total?
As you see here, total of more than 50 students are present here, and they have witnessed today's program.
Sir, how much do you think?
Especially they will come to know about the rights which they have been given by the Constitution. The main topics which was covered in today's programs was about the rights which the Constitution of India has provided to every citizens, and the limitations of the rights, if the rights are violated, what are the remedies for the violations of the rights, all these were discussed in today's program. And I think and I believe that it's quite beneficial for all of the students and for everyone attending today's program. Especially the part which Arunachal Pradesh State Legal Service Authority is bestowed upon is like providing free legal aid services. I would like to take the opportunity and would like to also inform you through your channel that Arunachal Pradesh State Legal Service Authorities has engaged our students as a para-volunteers, and we promise that our para-volunteers in collaboration with Arunachal Pradesh State Legal Service Authority will do the best for the society.
Thank you, sir.